Good evening, and welcome to Resonance 104.4 FM. I'm Will Luscombe, and in parallel to Black History Month, I bring you another brief history of the blues, this evening concentrating on some of the women of the blues. I'd also like to dedicate this evening's clear spot to my girlfriend, whose birthday is today. The female blues singers of the 20th century are not as well known as their male counterparts, though they certainly sang with no less intensity or emotion. Because they've perhaps been underrepresented, I would like to give you a brief snapshot of some of my favourite, and in some cases some of the most seminal, female blues singers. We begin this evening with the recently deceased Coco Taylor, an American blues singer with a rough and traditional style of delivery. She was commonly known as the Queen of the Blues. She began singing in Chicago blues clubs in the late 1950s and was spotted by Willie Dixon in 1962. This led to wider recognition and her first recording contract. In 1965, Taylor was signed by Chess Records, for whom she recorded Wang Dang Doodle, a song written by Dixon and recorded by Howling Wolf 5 years earlier. The song became a hit and reached number 4 on the R&B charts in 1966, selling over 1 million copies. Taylor recorded several versions of Wang Dang Doodle over the years, including a live version at the 1967 American Folk Blues Festival, with harmonica player Little Walter and guitarist Hound Dog Taylor. So, without further ado, here is Coco Taylor performing Wang Dang Doodle with Little Walter and Hound Dog Taylor.
We gonna pitch a ball.
Next, we will hear Taylor singing I Got What It Takes, a song which not only illustrates her searing and emotive vocal style, but is also typical of the 1960s Chess House style. Our last track from Coco Taylor is a disturbing and rousing rendition of Insane Asylum. Here she duets with her mentor Willie Dixon, whose delivery, in part, seems to ape that of Screaming Jay Hawkins.
To the insane asylum, and I found my baby out there. I said, please come back to me, darling. What in the world are you doing here? Then the little girl raised up her head. Tears were streaming down from her eyes. And these are the things that the little girl said.